Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Asgard and welcome back to Project Ozone. So I spent literally all yesterday, all my free time. I was doing some stuff, involving Easter and everything, but I spent pretty much my entire day, as far as free time goes, working on this pack. So I did get quite a bit done in that time, a fair amount anyway. You probably noticed immediately I know I released a sneak peek, couple pictures on Twitter, Facebook, and on Discord of the greenhouses. And so right now I've got four of them built out. To give you an idea, this is what they look like inside. And you can see the crops are growing. I mean, this thing is harvesting nonstop. It's got plenty of power and everything, but it's harvesting nonstop and it still can't keep up with the plant growth. Basically, I went ahead and automated lily pads of fertility because they're actually really, really cheap with our mob farm. I went ahead and automated those, and basically, I've just got them around. I know I could actually put them down a level, like put them under the floor, and just do a whole floor of lily pads. And it would be faster, but I mean, this is fast enough. I mean, it can't even keep up, so there's really no point in it. And also the sprinklers. They're running. There's a mod in the pack called No More Rain. That's why we never see the rain. And it also affects the sprinkler, so we can't actually see the water coming down. But if it's spinning, it means it's running. And those are, helping to boost the speed growth too. Honestly, it's just an insane amount of stuff coming in. Right over here, we have, a lot of the magical crops and these agricraft crops that really aren't that important to us, but we have those set up. And then on this side, more magical crops. This one back here, I haven't done. Basically, I'm just building out the ones that are finished. Also, those blocks right there, those are enchanted with, or painted with glowstone. So they do emit light as well. So, and let's see, this is the top of them, by the way. It's all Alf class, since we now have our portal. I was kind of hoping to get that soon because I wanted to do Alf class. And these are Alf class panes. So, also, I do know that the walkway is very narrow, but keep in mind that this is the back of the house. This isn't going to be a traffic area. I mean, right now we have our exit to to the island there, but that's not going to be there too much longer, honestly. This will be like a no traffic area. So, I mean, all it's going to be is like an industrial greenhouse type area, so I do want it compact. I wanted it, to fit in nicely back here and everything. Also, this one here, I left the top off of this one so you can see how I've got the sprinkler system set up. So basically, from here, like to this corner and to that corner and to there, that's all wooden irrigation channels that just kind of run a circle around this. And then the center, I just have wooden water tanks, three of those for each direction. And then in the middle, I just have infinite water. So, and then it runs all eight of the sprinklers. So those infinite water blocks aren't terribly expensive to make. We've made those before. And it keeps this whole thing running beautifully. I absolutely love it. And I think it looks very, very nice. Plus, with a combination of mana glass, alf glass, and the glowstone blocks there, we don't need any kind of light. So the torches, the ones that are finished, there's no torches there anymore either. So we're starting to get some of the light situated. Also over here, I actually haven't lit this area up, so do forgive me. But this I just set up real quick. It's basically just a farming station with one of our magical wooden mattocks in it. I have noticed this thing drains through a lot of power when it cuts down the trees. But basically it's just a wood farm. So very, very easy to set up. And then basically it just pumps down into our ender chest. You'll notice, I mean, it just cut down some trees and just chunked through a lot of power. These things are very, very expensive on power. But it's doing the trick. We have a ton of wood. So, and then I started laying out the fences here. We still have a huge gaping hole in the wall here. I haven't got that all sorted yet. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with the greenhouses, honestly. And as far as farming goes, that's not all. Back behind me here, I finally got netherwort seeds. And I've just got some dark ethereal glass here that you step through. And we have brown mushroom spores, netherwort, and red mushroom spores. And you'll notice, I mean, this area is dark. Of course, we have night vision, so you can't tell it, but I mean, we have magnum torches, so it doesn't matter. Nothing's going to spawn here. And then the back here, I just have a farming station that's running with a double layer capacitor in it with the magical wooden mattock. So, very, very nice. And this is just a right above this is an infinite water source, or infinite water block, and then it just goes down to the tank and comes over here. So, and then I've just got standard reinforced dark glass here, so you can kind of see out, you know, through the water. I'm actually fairly happy with it. It's, you know, it's kind of just tucked away, because I was thinking about farming nether wart, and I placed it down. I was like, wait, this can't grow here. I was like, cool. And so I went ahead and just built that out as well. So I'm fairly happy with it. Also, let's poke through here a little bit. Let's see. Over here in our chest, I made up a bunch of Elementium and Terrasteel, basically to finish out the quest. So we do have a block of Terrasteel and a block of Elementium for our Master Infusion Stone. So now all we're missing is that compressed Gaia. So, fun stuff. I basically, to make all this Terrasteel, I went through a few hundred levels, but a few hundred levels when you have like nearly 700 levels, I think I used up like 30, 40 levels from that. I think we're at 666 right now. Mark of the Beast. When I started running through that, we were at... Because at first I was doing it kind of passively, and then I just threw a bunch in there, or did a bunch of levels to kind of gun through the last of the Terrasteel and Elementium that I wanted to make. You can see the mana pool still haven't recovered from it. But I basically just let the Hydrangeas do part of the work, and then boosted the last little bit of it. And I want to say we were at like 692 or something like that. So you can see, I mean, 30 levels from that is about what I used. So it's not terrible. Also, I cleaned this up. I put some little blocks back here so you can't see past the mana spreaders. But that system is still working beautifully. I love it. Absolutely love it. Oh, by the way, up front, I think the only magical crop that I bred was coal. And then I did the spores, and then I did a couple Pam's Harvestcraft. I didn't do a whole lot of seed leveling, honestly. Also, our system is completely out of coal right now because I was using it all to make all this plastic. We have almost 25 million millibuckets of plastic at the moment. Let's see. I put this up here. I'm kind of started to work on this like balcony, this front balcony type area. Nothing too crazy up there. Also, I did automate sag mills finally. Finally got around to that because I was doing a lot of automation crafting with our system, trying to work towards a couple things that I want to get into in the near future. So I did add that there. I also added a buffer finally for the equipment chest or the loot recycler. I did add a buffer chest for that. Let's see, and then I think over here, I'll show you a couple other things. Just really, really quickly, I did do a lot of auto-crafting. Now, not all these are filled. Honestly, this top row has nothing in it, but the bottom row is about filled. I just ordered up a bunch of crafters to kind of add some in there. But you'll notice I've started automating solar panels. So right now, I've automated solar panel rank 1 and rank 2. Automating this actually took a lot of steps because I had to teach you how to make like brass, and you have to crush down copper and zinc and do all of that. And there's actually a few steps to the machine housing, as you can tell, and I taught it how to make carbide. Like, it was just a bunch of little odd and end steps, and there's a bunch of other you know, just odd and end things in there. I was working towards solar panels because I did add another thing in here. I would like to do the solar arrays, so because we need to start looking into future power. It's not anything that we need right this second, but we are going to have to start taking that stuff into consideration. Also, we're building up a fair amount of Zavisio, as you can see. And also, like wood, we have 7,613 wood. And alloys, like nearly, 8,500 energetic alloy. Pulsating iron is actually taking a little while, but it doesn't have the speed boost. When I put down these sprinklers to those greenhouses, it boosts that speed so crazy. It really does. Also, I moved this wire over to this side because what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to have an area here, probably along the wall here, where we can actually see items moving through the network, kind of coming in from the farms. And then I'm also going to do, right now, you know, the white inner chest pretty much just feeds into the drawer system. I'm going to alter that just so that we can have like a little area like right over here, I think. That way we can see the items, and it's just going to basically pull from the white inner chest and then probably just send it down to the drawer system, possibly through another ender chest gateway or something. But I just want to have, like, basically a spot in the wall where we can look up and see how much stuff is coming into the system. Because that's what's so cool about logistics pipes, I think. And it would be really, really cool because if you look at this, I mean, stuff's just kicking through. Very, very nice. A lot of things coming in, by the way. Actually, I did have a couple issues at a couple different points. I was down there working on farms, and all of a sudden I turned around and... Anyways, I turned around and my greenhouses... Those agricraft farming stations are weird because if they get filled, they'll still harvest the plant, but they'll just throw the items on the ground where they were. And so I turned around and there's just literally probably hundreds of items just packed into the greenhouse, like pumpkins and all that stuff. It was the, like where the pumpkins and the wheat and stuff is planted. There was just items everywhere. I was like, oh man, we have a, stuff has gotten stuck up. And I looked and it was Lumium was one of the things that I didn't have in here. And also rubber. I had forgotten to add those, and that was bad because it had gotten so backed up. It was chucking stuff everywhere. But now everything's pretty well sorted. Everything has void upgrades, and I made a bunch of emerald upgrades. Also, over here, you'll notice I didn't add a whole lot of essences to this. But if we take a look at, like, eggplant, we have 32,000 eggplant, 35,000 garlic. This Pam's Harvestcraft stuff at 10-10-10 with the sprinklers grows crazy fast. Really, really does. So yeah, that's the main things I've been working on. There is one other thing I've been working on that you'll see shortly. So anyways, today what I want to work on is I want to start working towards plugging up spawn. Now I will say this is not enough viaducts, not by any stretch of the imagination, but today we will go over the viaducts and we'll use what we have at the moment just to use them up. Because I do, you know, we actually have a teleporter for mechanism, so technically we could just plug up our spawn with the teleporter, but I think the viaducts would be more fun. Plus it kind of fits, I think, more with what we're doing, you know, because where we could do like applied energistics or something, instead we're doing actual item transport that you can see. So I'd rather do player transport that you can see as well, because it kind of matches up more. But I did build this little area out here, and there's actually a door right here. I do need to put a carpenter's block pressure plate there, but anyways, I built this out. This is spawn. So this is the spot where you spawn at, is right here. And this is where we're going to plug up our viaduct system. So you can also see that I did put a magnum torch down here. And I crafted up three more of these. I put on the big mountain areas near our base, I actually put down magnum torches there. So we don't have like a ton of mobs spawning on the mountains. You know, right around our base, because it honestly, it drove me insane, because I would look and see like a ton of mobs, and I was actually, I don't know if you noticed it, you'll see it later, but I did trim away some of those mountains so they didn't overhang over our base so much when I was putting the tree farm and stuff down, because I just use vein miner to clean those up. It's actually very, very effective, especially when you have good food to recover from it. But mobs kept falling on me, and so I was like, okay, I'm gonna put down a magnum torch, and sometimes I was getting shot by arrows. It was actually kind of a headache, so I just threw a magnum torch up there, and then I put one on the other side near that giant tree that we have over there. So anyways, for our viaduct system, I think what I'm going to do is we are going to use long-range linking viaducts, honestly. And so really, I mean, we'll use a couple viaducts, but our primary usage is going to be the long-range linking and the long-range viaducts. So this isn't really going to get us terribly far. You can see right here where I ordered a bunch of item speed upgrades. Because now, I mean, honestly, we are set on gold. We have 6,000 already. And that's after ordering quite a few things that took a bunch of gold. I'll tell you what, I'm going to get a crafting module. I'm going to sort these for now because I'll do these after the episode. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to teach you how to make fused quartz. And then I'm going to teach it how to make long range viaducts, I do believe. So basically we're just going to say if you take 4 nether quartz, you're going to get a fused quartz. Now you can also do this with lumium and obsidian. Oh, I didn't order nearly enough of these, did I? There we go. Now we got 5 of them. So what we're going to do is we're just going to say if you take 4 nether quartz, then you're going to get a Fused quartz, and we're just going to do this for all of these. All right, so that's all done. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to... Let me throw some of this stuff back that we don't really need right this second. And I'm going to just order quite a bit of fused quartz. Let's say 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8... We'll say 12 stacks minus 1 because I had that loose one. All right, so 767 fused quartz. So that way you can run while we're messing around with this, and I'll show you how this, you know, viaducts work. And I was debating if I want to go underground or above ground. I think I'm going to do kind of a mix of both. So we'll have some sections where you kind of come out of the hill and, you know, go across and stuff like that. So basically, just to give you an idea with the viaducts, let's see. Get him. He's like, hi, pay attention to me. I think what we're going to do is we're just going to come out of this, like through this hole right here, and I'll just put that there, I guess. Yeah. And so what we're going to have to do is we're going to have a viaduct to start with, right? And then what you can do is you just right click to open it, and you can set a name to this. We're going to say spawn. And then if we pop out here, there is a blue slime island up there. That's why these are kind of popping down. I killed a few of them earlier while I was working on this stuff. And we'll just kind of have our viaduct come out like that. And then I think, do we want to have the long range one immediately? I think so. But if we were to put this like right here, you can hit spawn and kind of zip through there. As you can see, and if you go into third person, you can kind of see yourself. It is pretty fast right now because it's just right through the wall. But you can use these viaducts to travel like a hamster. And so what we're going to do is we're going to put our long range linking viaduct right here. And we'll just open those up. And then we're going to have to use long range viaducts. There we go. From this point on. Viaducts can't be used within a long range system. So if you notice, if I put that there, it does not connect. So if we were to put long range in here and we were to hit, there we go. Searching on side east, it linked. So now if we go to spawn, you'll notice it stops right here and it says charging, and it's got to go all the way up to 120. So if you're not really going long range, those are not worth using. I'll go ahead and tell you. I believe to make them actually useful, if I recall correctly, and I could be mistaken on this, but it has to be at least like 30 blocks or something like that to really reach the point where it's effective to use a long range linking. So just keep that in mind. And another thing to note is you can't change Y level with these. So if I try to go up, you see that these aren't connecting. And then if I was to come out here and say do a long range linking viaduct, even right there, that's fine. As long as there's a Y level change. And then I came out here, you see searching on side east, it does nothing. It just keeps saying it's failed because it's a different Y level. Those will not connect. So you do have to keep this at the same Y level. So we're just going to kind of bring it through and head off in this direction. I should probably go, tell you what, we're just going to mark. And I think what we're going to do is we're going to have the viaduct come out like right in here. We'll say Y level 30, that's fine. Okay, so our spawn position is dead off in that direction. I'd say about right in, actually about right in here is probably good. So what we're going to do is we're just going to connect up our long range viaducts through here. And I will say I'll come back through here and make like a tunnel and decorate it and all that. That's going to be very time consuming. So I'm not going to do it right this second. So just a heads up. I will come back through though. And yeah, we're going to need about 250 viaducts. So a little bit expensive, but honestly, resources aren't really an issue. All right, we're already out of those. So let me pop on over and get a bunch more. This is going to take a little while, so. Yeah, I'm thinking if we had... I kind of want the viaducts to come out, like, right here. So you kind of come into the garden-type area, because there is going to be some stuff here on the left, and just kind of have the viaducts come through, and then they'll come down and connect into here. It's kind of funny, because as I run... Oh, do I have the Amulet of Growth on me? No? For some reason, when I run by these trees, they all grow. I don't know why that is. I have no clue whatsoever. It's only whenever I sprint, too. I guess it's counting it as twerking or something. So what we're going to do is we're just going to set up a quick recipe here for long-range viaducts. So we're going to say 4 copper, 4 fused quartz, and then we'll set up a quick recipe. We'll say, I think it's like this, right? Yeah. That's going to get long-range viaducts. We'll go ahead and apply that. We'll grab 8 of those, and we'll configure it to the recipe. Really, that's not going to be that expensive, honestly, since it does make 8 at a time. So we'll say make 8, and there we go. So now I'm going to go ahead and just order a few of these. Let's say, I'm going to say 320. And I'm going to pop over here because I love watching these big crafts. So here are all the items. Here's some of the items come anyway. Looks like there went... Oh, that was eggplant that just went through. Here we go. Wonderful. I think that's it. Yeah, there we go. That's simple. I'm just waiting until we have all those logistics pipes sped up. I will tell you, though, just a heads up, if you want full-speed logic pipes, it's very, very expensive. That's why I made up so many stacks of those upgrades, because you can actually do 64, 64, 64, 64 across all this. And you can have, I mean, that's how you full-speed a viaduct, is just to do, a, like, what is it, like 9 or 10 stacks of, before I leave, go ahead and get full jetpack here. But it does... I mean, it requires a ton of those speed upgrades. That's why, you know, I wanted gold so bad, is because we're going to be eating through gold, like, so fast. Anyways, I'll be back in just a bit. I'm going to keep running these out, these long-range viaducts. It's going to take a little bit. Oh, if you want to see something really, really funny, watch this. I just noticed this. Okay, so we're, like, 200 meters from our spawn, and then the wireless charger is, like, off in the, you know, logic pipe room. If I turn off hover for a second, we go up to 100%. So my wireless charger is reaching all the way out here as well. I feel like that's like a super range. I don't feel like it's normally that much. Because like, yeah, I know in 1.10, like my Direwolf series, I have to have like, I actually have like a, one of those in each tower, you know, a wireless charger. I want that. So anyways, I'm going to continue running these over. It's actually not that bad with hover and everything. Okay, so we're actually kind of like, I've dug right above the spawn location. And I think, at least for now, this actual approach into the base is subject to change, I'll go ahead and say. Because I don't know for sure, you know, I haven't set up the stuff, you know, in the gardens off in that direction just yet. So I don't know for sure what's going to be over here. There is going to be like a little section kind of to make it, you know, fit and have, I don't know, it may just be decorative. So for right now, we're just going to kind of come down from the top and kind of come into this, you know, basically the output for the system. But that is subject to change. So just a heads up. But I'm going to go ahead and set up a viaduct here, and we're going to say this is going to be home gardens. Home and gardens. So then what we're going to do is, of course, you can't change Y level with the long range linking viaducts. So I'm going to just run these up. I think we have enough of these to make it work. And I'm just going to make a quick waypoint marker right there that just says here, so I can kind of figure out exactly where we're coming in from. Actually, didn't take a whole lot of time to make all those and run this, realistically. Okay, yeah, we've got a decent amount that we need to come down, it looks like. First, I was thinking we couldn't get this done today because I was, for some reason, I was thinking the long-range viaducts took the Xerothium as well, but no. So I'm thinking, like, right in here would be a good place to end the long-range viaducts. So, like, right there. And then we'll kind of bring them out just a couple more. Yeah, right here is the end of it. So what we're going to do is we are going to just have the long range come to like right here. And then we're going to have a long range linking viaduct. We'll just set this up right here. Searching on side west, it was linked to somewhere. Chances are it was our other long range linking viaduct. Because these can only link to other linking viaducts. So I'm going to assume yes. And then what we'll do is we'll just bring our viaducts down. Kind of break through this wall here. There we go. And connect that up. Da-da-da. So now we have a hamster line that kind of runs all the way to spawn. So if we wanted to take it, you'll be able to see the viaducts in action here. We're going to go to spawn. And you can see that we're kind of just flying through the tunnels. Meow. And now it's charging up. Okay. So basically once it finishes charging, we're going to go extra fast through this. So you can see that. Only thing is I can't really turn my camera, but... Woo! So much fun. I love viaducts so much. And there we are. We're at spawn. So now, if something happens, we die, our bed's not linked, all we have to do is just pop into here and say home and gardens. And of course it's going to charge. It charges like right as soon as you leave the tunnel right there. And then pow! I do love this so much. So, so good. I love that tree right there. I wish you could turn your camera a little bit more. Well, that was weird. It was like the gates were closed or something. And then here we are at the Homan Gardens. Wonderful. Wonderful stuff. We may do more with viaducts. I mean, like I said, I'm going to clean that up and add like an actual like decorative tunnel that you kind of go through with like glowstone circles and stuff like that. But we may end up doing more with viaducts and even using it to move around the base, possibly. I don't know. I wouldn't mind having that instead of the elevators. Well, the only thing is I like pneumaticraft elevators a lot, too. I don't really like open blocks elevators, personally. I know they're convenient and everything, but I like travel that actually you travel in the process of going through it. I don't like instantaneous travel, personally. I don't like travel anchors. I don't like elevators. I love viaducts, and I love pneumaticraft elevators. So, so much. And if there's Thaumcraft, I like the elevators from Thaumcraft as well. So, but I don't know. We may do viaducts for an elevator system as well as the pneumatics elevators for like different places or something like that. Or use viaducts for moving around the base and use elevators for moving floors. So, anyways, moving on. I'm pretty happy with that. That's kind of more of a fun setup than anything and something that I'd been wanting to do. For a bit. We still have a few long-range viaducts. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and mark that off of our clipboard. I do have to decorate it, but spawn is now connected, technically. So, I'm happy with it. Now, today, the other thing that I want to work on is we're going to be doing a little bit of adventuring. It's not, like, today we're not doing as much of, like, what we normally do. Like, with, you know, building and doing machines and all that stuff. You know, we kind of did the viaducts, and now, the rest of the day, we're going to spend kind of... It's not a little bit of exploration and a bit of gearing up because, you know, realistically, we could fight the Gaia Guardian if we wanted to. We could take him on, but we're not prepared as far as armor goes. I mean, we're in terrible shape with armor. So that's what we're going to be working on. Also, I did look at the Witherless Rose because I was curious. I was like, man, I'd love to have a Witherless Rose, actually. Yeah, these things require 4 Nether Stars, Rose Bush, and some fertile essence. We may end up making that, though, before too long, because it would be very, very handy to have. Because we're going to have to actually fight the Wither a few times before we can get Wither seeds up and going. I don't know. Actually, the dragon might not be that bad. So, I don't know. But anyways, we're going to be working on armor. And the first step is just leather armor. And of course, this upgrades into the chain. The chain armor upgrades into the iron. And then we have to get lapis. I mean, there's a few different steps here. Let me grab a bit of that stuff. I'm just going to grab 2 stacks of iron. Let's get like a stack of lapis and then say a stack of leather. Okay. That should be good to get us started. These first few steps aren't going to be terribly exciting, but in this pack, you really have to rank up your armor. You can't just, I want diamond armor. Let me make that real quick. It's very much a process of tiering it up. So, and then from here, we're going to need a bunch of iron bars. Like 48 is probably plenty. And then we need to make chain armor. And then from there, we need to make iron armor. And then lapis armor. And then from lapis, let's see. We need to do osmium. Let's see. And then from osmium is bronze. And then from bronze is steel. Okay, so let me get a bit of osmium, steel, and bronze. Osmium and steel. And then we get to get into a bit more exciting stuff, at least for me personally. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. Because, I mean, we're going to be doing a bit of exploration and stuff this episode. And just kind of a breakaway from the norm for us. As well as something that we really, I mean, we have to do it. We have to gear up right now. Because we're moving into the phase where we're going to have to actually start taking on bosses. And I can't take bosses on with 5, 6 defense. It's just, it's not going to be a thing, you know. So we got our osmium. Almost wondering if it would be, like, worth it to just... I don't think we'd really need any more after this. Like, one set. If I find that we end up using it more, I may automate this stuff because it's kind of tedious to craft it. I mean, it only takes like a couple minutes so far, but it's very tedious. Okay. Now, from steel, we're going to have to do xanite. Now, I do actually have some xanite crystals. I was looking earlier to see what all I had and what all I was going to need and things like that to get an idea. Before we move forward, though, because we're going to be getting into a little bit of exploration stuff, I do want to get a bag of holding. Oops. I want to get a bag of holding. And just like this, yeah, most likely is wonderful. Okay, I have to go get a block of gold real quick. So, we will, by the way, one thing I do want to do, possibly next episode, I know we're going to be fighting the Guy of Guardian, or the Guy of Guardian, possibly next episode. I doubt we're going to get it done today just because we're going to be doing a bit of other stuff. But we will probably quickly fight the Gaia Guardian next episode and see how it goes. But the other thing that I would really like to do probably next episode is work on our, you know, we earlier, before we set up the autonomous activator to open those loot bags, right? I would like to set up some kind of a system to really, you know, start working on really automating that. You know, handling all the iron armor coming in, handling all the horse armor coming in. I mean, that stuff's going to get broken down. I'll go ahead and tell you, the iron armor, you know, gold armor, any of that stuff that comes in, it's going to get melted down, create blocks. That way we have iron blocks, gold blocks on hand. The same with horse armor. Chances are I may maybe throw down like a storage drawer and say like, you know, get, you know, so many of these. And then after that, burn the rest of them, I think is what I'm probably going to do. So we'll go ahead and order that stuff. Get our, oh, we're waiting on a chest, okay. And there's our golden bag of holding. Just because anytime that I'm, you know, we're really setting out to do a bit of exploration, I would like to have some kind of item storage, personally. And golden bag of holding is my personal favorite. I mean, it's a massive, massive storage item without really being all that expensive, honestly. I mean, we do have this knapsack. I always forget that it's there. We probably actually use that knapsack for like a tool bag type thing, probably. But while we've got the golden bag of holding, let's go ahead and enchant it. And we're going to say it's got reincarnating 1. And basically that just means if I do happen to die, then the bag's going to stay on me. It will break the reincarnating, but that's perfectly fine. I'm not too concerned about that. Okay, so let's take a look here. I've got in one of these chests that really I need to get around to sorting, I have, there we go. There's some xanite. We've also got some gravitite ore, some ambrosian shards. We're going to be needing this stuff today. So, honestly, I think we have enough xanite to go ahead and upgrade this stuff to xanite leggings and or xanite armor. And the xanite. Now we're going to need exoskeleton stuff. So this is where it gets fun. Exoskeleton plates, and we're actually going to need more of these because I know right now we're making the exoskeleton chest plate, and from there we're going to need jade. We've actually got plenty of jade. And then we need the reinforced exoskeleton chest plate. These require 9 for each reinforced exoskeleton. So very, very expensive. And then from there, we're going to need gravitite. Then we can make diamond, and then we can make titanium. Spectre chest plate, and then get into the actual magical crop stuff. So fun stuff, let me tell you. Honestly, with us needing that many exoskeleton pieces, I think what we're going to do is let me get, I'm gonna grab just 2 soul vials actually. Originally, I was like, well, we'll go there and we'll grind and you know all that. No, I don't think so. Oh, by the way, I almost forgot. I don't know why. We have a lot of quests done. You can see we've got 9 quests here. Let's go ahead and go over them just really, really quickly. We do have Sieving Montage 2 completed. I went ahead and did that because if you notice, I used amaranth wood. I was looking at like the colors that I had there and the color scheme I was working on. I was like, I really want amaranth. So I just did some topiary grass, and then I went ahead and made some bluegrass and autumnal grass. Basically, you just dye the grass, you know, and this is just dirt and seeds. So I did make some of that. And I got that sieving, just it's on auto save. It basically just feeds into a chest, and I just manually fill it. But let's get our reward bag from that. And then over here in beta, we have a couple done. We have the passive farm. I went ahead and got pork chops and eggs because I am working. I don't know if you noticed at the start, but I have a couple magical crops that I'm working on. I'm actually working on pig seeds and chicken seeds, as well as experience seeds. So we're going to go ahead and turn this in. We do get to pick either a cow, sheep, chicken, or pig. I'll take a cow. I doubt it's going to be a fluid cow one, but. And then we also completed the Elven Dreams quest. So we're going to go ahead and take this reward bag. The next part, of course, is the Gaia Guardian stuff. We'll get into that very, very soon. Honestly, I want to start working on the carrots fairly soon as well. So. But anyways, then in Gamma, basically I finally did this transfer node quest, and I had to make the breadth first, the pseudo round robin, and the depth first. These really aren't expensive. They just require a bunch of redstone and then doing upgrades and stuff like that. But anyways, we get a chance cube from that. And then Angel Block, of course, this is cheap. I just made one just to do it. And that's going to get us another reward bag. And then we've got Iron Drum. We had already done that. It just auto-completed. We got a chance cube from that. Magical wood, 30 of those. I had to make some of those, but you know, it wasn't any big deal. And we'll take this reward bag here. Bedrockium, which we had already auto-completed that one. We're gonna take this reward bag. And then, yeah, that's it. No. Oh yeah, unstable ingots. I went ahead and did this. I totally forgot about this. You can actually make these nuggets here that take gold over diamond, and these nuggets are stable, so you can actually use them, and then you can turn them into unstable ingots that are stable. And I actually have some. Let me go ahead and grab that reward bag there. But if you look in here, we have say 7 unstable ingots. And then 1 semi-stable. I made like a stack of semi-stable nuggets. So you will eat through the uses on your division sigil a bit quicker, but honestly, that division sigil ritual really isn't any kind of problem to do again or anything. But anyways, let's go ahead and open all these up. We've got alchemical coins, transmutable EMC source, converted to aether coins and vice versa using the coin meal. Okay, we'll take those. And then we got all this stuff from Mr. Crayfish again. And that cow spawn, I'm going to throw into here. I'm just going to throw that stuff in there temporarily as storage, kind of. I know I'm terrible. But then we've got, oh, we've got two basic reward bags. We got an iron paxel crap reward. And Mr. Crayfish again. Awesome. We're going to have so many appliances. I'm probably going to start an appliance store, I think. I've literally gotten that reward like 5 times. And then we have greater reward bag. This one, we have a maximum speed bow from the Erebus and 64 arrows. And then we got 44 heart glass. Yeah. Okay. So actually, we didn't get anything too great, if I'm being perfectly honest. I'm just going to throw that in there temporarily. Let's go ahead and head on to the Erebus. And like I said, originally I was planning on grinding once we got there. But yeah, I don't... Oh, that's the wrong place. I don't think we're going to do that. I think we're going to do something a little bit different. Alright, so basically what we're going to be looking for is beetles. And I will say that we're probably going to spend an episode in the very near future just playing around in the Erebus. Because the Erebus and the Aether both add a ton of stuff. What is that that I just passed up? Oh, copper. Okay. The Erebus and the Aether both add a ton of stuff that we haven't really messed with thus far. And stuff that we would really kind of benefit from, like beetle taming, would be so much fun. It really, really would. There's a beetle. We can actually take that one, in fact. For example, if I run over here and I was to kill this beetle, you can see that they move extremely fast. They're kind of a pain to kill. But it does drop a single exoskeleton plate. They actually take a little while to kind of grind up, honestly. But speaking of, there's a couple things involving animal taming that I would love to get into with you guys. This does have, I guess I could put looting on this sword. These guys actually do a bit of damage, not gonna lie. And these aren't even the strong beetles either. Okay. Okay. Hey, I need you, actually. There we go. Been killing those whenever I see them because I saw that we needed all that Spectre iron. But even I think even with looting, this would still take a while because you can see, I mean, beetles aren't, like, just everywhere. So what we're going to do is we're going to go make a spawner for beetles instead. You know, it's kind of a use for some of that XP that we've been building up, and then in addition, it'll make life so much easier. And by the way, I was actually thinking about one change that I might do. Might even start working on it before next episode. But if you recall, in our spawner area, we have like this big area here that's going to have spawners in it, right? And then I've got all this cursed earth mess over here. Well, what if instead we did this floor as cursed earth and then had the spawners here for like all of our special mobs, and we could even like put them up and line them up and everything, and then have all the mobs sent to one side with iron spikes or diamond spikes on it, or you know, whatever we're using to kill the mobs off. Honestly, I may end up using something with like decapitating and maybe looting on it, but have all the mobs funneled down there to be killed and just have it like a super multi-farm, you know, with all different kinds of things spawning. It would be like the center of all lag ever, but I don't know. I mean, it's a thought anyways, so we shall see. But I think what we're gonna do is let's break this off. We're gonna run some power under the floor here and just plug this up. You know, we could make it just a mine factory reloaded grinder as well. Yeah, let me go grab an ender sword because we have a bunch of those. We may even have one down in this chest, honestly. I think we'll just do a Mine Factory Reloaded Grinder for right now. Later on, we're going to upgrade it. But for right now, I think this will be fine. Just for auto-killing our mobs for us. And so there's our grinder. And then let me get just a octatic capacitor. Honestly, this requires 3,200 RF per work. It's not that bad, really. I know I have bats flying around the base. I need to get that cleaned up. But I think what we'll do is we'll put our grinder. Yeah, we'll put it over here. Step off onto this real quick. So put it right there. And that's got power. Wonderful. And then I think what we're going to do is let's pop down here. Basically, I just want to run power over to like right there. That's where our spawner will be. This thing may eat a bit of power because if you recall, when we tried this before, when I was using the spawner for capture mode, it did eat through quite a bit of power, honestly. Really, really did. So next up, we're going to need a broken spawner. I don't know that I have any on me, but oh, I don't have Wither Essence. Shoot. Because that, I need Tempurio to get that. So, I guess... Oh, I do have this broken zombie spawner. Where did we get that from? Oh, that's right. There was all those mine shafts, I think, was where I got it from. Right? Or something like that? No, I changed it over, didn't I? I changed it to a zombie spawner from a blaze spawner. Well, that's fine. We're going to use that. And then I've got my soul vial here for the beetle. And let's go ahead and get this thing running through the soul binder. So there's your beetle soul and your zombie spawner. And then let me get 20 levels here, which is going to put like a major dent in this. All right, so there's 20. Oh my gosh, this thing drains so much power. Just like nom 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 power. Okay, beetle spawner. And then we just have to get ourselves a powered spawner. Don't we have one of these made somewhere? Okay, I guess we never made the second part. I know we made that Enderman spawner, but we never did the rest of it, so. It's crazy because we're about to actually dip into some levels today. Fun stuff. And there's that. And then we need, like, well, once we get this made, then we'll need, like, the 300 levels or whatever to bind it together. I think it's 300 if I recall. There we go, electrical steel Enderman head, and there's our powered spawner. Then all we need is a measly 300 levels. See, it's not really draining all that much from this. We still have 606 levels. And there's our powered spawner. Pa-pow. Wait, why is that? Oh, it was a visual bug. Okay. So we've got our beetle spawner. Wonderful. And so what we're going to do is we're just going to set this up right over here. And actually, this is going to have a place to output items, isn't it? I'll tell you what. Let me remove, I think right here is where, no, right here. I'm just going to remove that for a moment. Put this block back down. And of course, this is going to produce essence, so I'll tell you what, let me get a drum. I'll tell you what, let's get a piece of octuple. I'm already back up to 3. By the way, I did add a couple more capacitor, bedrock and capacitor things to the capacitor farm. It's like 2 more. So let's throw this into here. And we'll get our piece of bedrockium. Bedrockium ingots. I just noticed this it's reverse graphite and bedrockium. Okay. You'll notice we move like super slow when you're carrying bedrockium. And I want to make a drum. Bedrockium drum. And there we go. We should have everything now. We'll order the bedrockium back. I shouldn't have sent it away. And there's a bedrockium drum. And I believe we have enough to make... Yeah, I've got enough on me to make one more. Alright, and then I'm also going to want just some fluid conduits. Like, we'll grab like 2. That's... Honestly, I'll probably only need like 1, I think. And so we'll set our bedrockium drum. This is just going to be a temporary setup, by the way. Just a heads up. Put it right there. We'll put our fluid conduit right here. We'll say extract. And then, let me get just a diamond chest, I think. And there's one other thing I think I'm going to get. And this is for, like, a temporary setup. Basically, I don't want to have to set up the fans again. You know, those were fine before, but they're not really something I can just throw down. Yeah, there's a Magnum torch, by the way. They're not something that I can just quickly throw down and just be like, "Oh, here you go, Magnum torch." So what I'm gonna need is I'm gonna need a villager, and it looks like we don't have any available around here. So I'm gonna be off. I know there's another village off in this direction, so I'm gonna head for that right over here. Okay, captured him. And I'm going to make an attractor obelisk. So that way I can just basically pull the mobs over without having to push them or, you know, do any of that. I'd rather just kind of move them over passively near the grinder. So let me order an emerald real quick. Throw this and this and the soul binder. We're gonna need 15 levels, which levels is basically like, if levels are a currency, we're like Bill Gates at this point. We're earning more than we can use. I mean, we've actually used a lot of levels today, but they'll be back probably by next episode. You know, they come back so fast. I will say this this attractor obelisk is actually a little bit expensive. So I need to actually set up maybe a villager spawner set to capture, so that we can just order villager souls instead of actually, because I mean eventually we're gonna have to, you know, be going farther and farther out if I don't do something, either make a villager spawner system, which doesn't sound like any fun, or set them up in a spawner system like that. And our diamond chest is done, so I'm gonna grab that and let me get also. Let me get an item conduit, like two of those. Whoops, I want this, in fact. Attractor obelisk. Wasn't there a quest for that? Or was it like a quest for like a bunch of different obelisks or something of that nature? Was it Delta? Oh no, they wanted us to make a weather obelisk. Okay. I'm not so concerned about a weather obelisk, honestly. Because it, I mean, you can't see the rain on here anyway. Let's put our diamond chest. We'll just put it right here. Keep in mind this is just temporary. I just want a place where I can quickly, easily access the items. We're going to say extract, insert, and then we'll just pop over here. The attractor obelisk is going to require power. So what we're going to do is we are going to just pull that up. Put down a power line right there, and then we'll put the attractor obelisk right here. And range is 16 blocks. That's perfectly fine. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to put our powered spawner down, like right here. We'll throw a capacitor in it. And then what I want to do is just capture, you know, one of these beetles and throw its soul into the attractor obelisk. It could have to do with the fact that they're so big, maybe. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just pull that up. Oh no. Oh no, that was a bad idea. I guess I could just smack them and then they all come running. This isn't really a spawner that I need to run all the time right this second. But I'm thinking they probably just couldn't fit in there, and so they were just like, never mind. We're not interested in that. So maybe now if we put the beetle in there. Oh yeah, they all come running at it now. It was too tight of a corridor area, I guess. Okay, so that works. Now milkshake brings all the beetles to the yard. All right, so now if we pop over here, let's see. We are getting essence, and we're getting exoskeleton plates. Wonderful. That's so much better than actually having to manually farm those, because that would have been terrible. You'll notice where, I mean, we're getting a fair amount of those. So probably by the time we actually need the reinforced ones, we'll have enough exoskeleton plates to get the reinforced ones. And I know it is kind of messy down there, but I'll clean all that up later. You know. Everything is a work in progress at this point, so not too concerned about it. So anyways, we'll grab our Xanite stuff, and let's go ahead and upgrade this. Wonderful. Actually, having that stuff automated, the rest of it is fairly downhill from this point. And there we go. And we still have some exoskeleton left. Awesome. Okay. And now from this. By the way, I am going to remake all this armor at some point so we can have like an armor stand area, because there's a lot of really good armors in this mod. Like even the Erebus alone has some really cool armors that we'll get into in the future. But we'll go ahead and grab our jade. I'm going to go ahead and get the Spectre Iron as well. Look at all this exoskeleton plates. I love it. But I do want an area that just, it's nothing but armor stands, you know. I think that would look really, really cool. Okay, so we're going to upgrade all this stuff to jade now. And then from jade, now we need the reinforced exoskeleton. So this is where this part is a little bit expensive, I will say. Now I believe after this point, we need the gravitite. Yes. Okay, so right here, while that's grinding exoskeleton, because that's honestly, it's going to take a little while. If you recall this gravitite, we find it in the aether. And do that, in fact. If you recall, you have to enchant this stuff because when it's in ore form, you can't just cook it or anything like that. You actually have to throw it on the altar of light and then throw your ambrosia on there. That's how you get enchanted gravitite. Now, I only actually had one piece of gravitite left over from when we were in the aether, so I have to go do a bit of mining, but I'm gonna need a fair amount of this stuff. Now, one thing to note about gravitite, though, if you're having to mine a bunch of this, it does generally spawn around the bottom of the world. Because I know, like, lore-wise, if I recall correctly, gravitite is what makes these islands float. According to lore. I mean, if you take all the gravitite, it's not going to make the island just suddenly collapse. But I do believe that I believe that was the story behind it. All right, I tell you what, we're going to fly around on the bottom. That's generally a pretty safe bet. And let me actually just turn my magnet on here. And we'll just grab all this stuff that way. Right, I got 21 more gravitite, so we're good. We got well more than enough. Or way more than enough. One thing I don't believe I've shown you guys about gravitite that's actually really cool is if you take gravitite ore and you put it here, you'll notice it floats to the ceiling. Enchanted gravitite ore will do the same thing, except it works on redstone. So if you apply a redstone signal, it will float to the top. Otherwise, it's going to, stay down. So just a heads up on that in case you didn't know about that. But the Aether actually has some really cool stuff. We'll get into more of that as time goes on. I will go ahead and tell you. All right, so we have, honestly, I think we've got enough exoskeleton plates, I do believe. I do need to do something with all those loot bags. Probably have that feed into the compactor. All right, there's 27, and I've still got, enough to make some more as well. So let's go ahead. There's our headpiece. And then we can upgrade this chest piece on up to gravitite right now. Our legs up to gravitite. And then let me go make some more of this enchanted gravitite real quick. And I need to put some of this junk up because my inventory is like trashed. Okay, and there's the last of our gravitite stuff. And now we need, what is it, Spectre? No, it's diamonds next. Okay. All right, and then after diamond, now we need titanium. Let's see. And then after titanium, it is Spectre Iron. Okay. So we're almost there. Okay, and now we just need the Spectre Iron. Just like that. This stuff is easy. Easy enough to get. It's just ectoplasm and iron. Get you Spectre Iron. And we've actually got, that was just all the Spectre Iron that I just had lying around. We have a bunch of ectoplasm, though. Because I tend to kill those spirits anytime that I see them. I think we just need, what, 7, 11, 10, and then 10 ectoplasm. And we just combine it like that. Gets us our Spectre Iron. And there we go. So fun stuff. Now the next part is very, very, you've got to do a bunch of these, okay, like Axio ingots, and then you have to go to Crucio, Imperio, Zavisio. Okay, I'm going to do most of this off camera because Axio ingots requires mana steel and mana stone-infused mana essence, which is stone and then Manesio blocks. And then Crucio is mana steel and iron-infused mana essence, which is iron and Manesio blocks. And then Crucio Essence. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to automate this whole system, making all these ingots and all that stuff, just really, really quickly. And then I will be back in just a few. Okay, I've been automating all the ingots and working up the armor. So we're up to Imperio, and we should be able now. I do need to send this Mana Essence through. I'll send that in. We need to order 20 more Zavisio. Because it's 24 ingots per, basically, set of armor. And if we take a look here, you can see right here, Manesio blocks, stone-infused mana, Axio ingots, iron-infused mana, Crucio, gold-infused, Imperio, diamond-infused, and then Zavisio. Basically, this stuff just had a lot of steps, so I went ahead and cut for all of that. Mana essence, of course, if you get artifact armor, it can't be damaged. It has to be full durability. Like, for example, this artifact armor here, if I put it into the crafting grid, I get 4 mana essence. We will automate that once we automate the loot bag system. So just a heads up on that. But for right now, yeah. We can't automate that. So anyways, we got our Zavisio. Let's go ahead and make the last set of armor. There's the chest, and the boots actually go like that. Okay, quest complete, Zavisio armor. Now, this has been unlocking or doing a quest every single step. So we have 4 quests completed. We have Axio armor, we'll take this reward bag. Crucio armor, this reward bag. Imperio will take the middle one, and then Zavisio will take the one on the right-hand side. Oh, that's a legendary bag. Okay, so we got 2 good bags. Amulet of Growth and 2 diamond apples. Okay, that's from Extra Planets. I'm going to go ahead and just throw this stuff in here. I'm about to do a bit with sorting after this episode, so I don't mind. Greater bag, we got soap and soapy water and all that junk from Mr. Crayfish. I think he really likes us today. And then our legendary loot bag. Fingers crossed that we get something epic. Here we go. What? Jump boost. So basically we got 4 mana essence. Okay, that was crap. That was just the worst thing ever. Okay, so anyways, now we have our Zavisio stuff. You'll notice it says 96% damage reduction, negates fall damage, and it has flight. So we can get rid of our jetpack, and we can throw on some kind of a visual, there we go, visual bug. And this is what we look like. We look like a big purple people eater with a smiley face on our chest. It's probably one of the magical crops. Armor is not all that pretty, I have to say, but it is very, very effective. So now we have creative mode flight. You can see I can just fly around. Doesn't require any kind of limited energy or anything like that. If I drop, no fall damage. And this stuff has, if you notice, full armor. And it has an extra damage reduction. So we're up to 96% damage reduction. Honestly, I think we're ready for the Gaia Guardian. But I do know that it's about wrapping up point. Next episode when we come back, we are going to take on the Gaia Guardian. And we are going to kill the Gaia Guardian and get our Master Infusion Stone, I do believe. And then we may, honestly, we'll probably work on the loot bag system after that, I think, next episode. And that's my goal for next episode. Ooh, we don't have night vision with this. I'll do something. I'll figure out something. Maybe I'll just light everything up like it should be. But yeah, so we'll do Gaia Guardian, Master Infusion Stone, and then do something with the loot system, I do believe, next episode. And then the episode after that, I think we're going to do, we're going to begin working in the fluid room and work, you know, setting that up and getting that in place and everything. And then after that, we'll probably start moving in towards mechanism or something like that. So, and we'll probably check out, I may do a bit more work with the solar array automation, and so we might maybe make some solar panels next episode towards, I know we've got some quests for them and stuff. But yeah, I feel like we actually got a lot done today. You know, as far as armor, I mean, we went from being like really, really squishy to like really well armored in one episode. So very, very nice. And we got our nice viaduct system set up. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. And as always, if you did, be sure and hit that like button and go ahead and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. I love this view, by the way. And yeah, I hope to see you guys next time. And until then, as always, do take care, stay safe, and I will see you guys then.